Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus came to Jericho and intended to pass through the town. Now a man there named Zacchaeus, who was a chief tax collector and also a wealthy man, was seeking to see who Jesus was. But he could not see him because of the crowd, for he was short in stature. So he ran ahead and climbed the sycamore tree in order to see Jesus, who was about to pass that way. When he reached the place, Jesus looked up and said, "Zacchaeus, come down quickly, for today I must stay at your house." And he came down quickly and received him with joy. When they all saw this, they began to grumble, saying, "He has gone to stay at the house of a sinner." But Zacchaeus stood there and said to the Lord, "Behold, half of my possessions, Lord, I shall give to the poor. And if I have extorted anything from anyone, I shall repay it four times over." And Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, because this man too is a descendant of Abraham. For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save what was lost." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It is good to be back to St. William's. Before I go into the homily, my second homily, I have been sharing with you, but today, as a deacon, I would call it a homily. I want to thank Father Adrian and Deacon Rick, and all the St. William's parishioners, you are my family, for helping me to witness a great ordination. And now I am here at your service. As I was reflecting the Word of God, what I have to share with you, something touched my heart. The Word helped me to reflect a story that I'm going to share with you. I heard my call as a young boy, 4 years old, but that was just it. I was discerning as I was growing older until my adult age. One day I was sitting at our house reflecting, how is it possible that I want to go into this life, that I'm going to detach myself from everything? And I wasn't sure because I considered myself sinful. I was kind of judging myself. I wasn't merciful to myself. I said, no, I cannot do that. Because to go into priesthood, you have to be someone that is holy, someone that has no sin. That was my impression. But until I heard the reading from the wisdom book, that God does not choose someone who is just perfect, he came to call sinners. And he's a God that also chooses you without looking into those places that we condemn ourselves. A God that gives us chance to be able to walk through it. It's a God that gives us chance to see who we are and steps back and repent, moving forward to embrace him. God that does not support our destruction of ourselves. That was what I heard. I said, God, so I could go into this life, into this vocation. I went out, I saw my mom sitting in front of our house. I made my first public announcement that I'm going to pursue this vocation to become a priest. And I shared this with my friends, knowing that he could walk with me. And that's also what we heard in the gospel. Jesus put it into practice as a forgave Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus, when I was also in the first Sunday school, when I heard the story of Zacchaeus, they said a short man who was a tax collector, a sinful man, he heard that Jesus was on his way.
He ran, avoided all the crowd. He climbed a sycamore tree to be able to see Jesus, not knowing that Jesus himself, who knew him before he was born, could see him. And Jesus, as he was passing, he noticed him and called him, "Zacchaeus, come down. Today, I must go to your house." And that's the good message I want to tell you today. If you open your heart and climb your own sycamore trees without letting the crowd of destruction, the crowd of destruction, the crowd of sinful self-condemnation, the crowd of pride, the crowd of hatred, prevent you from seeing Christ, climb your own sycamore trees, and Jesus will see you. He will notice you and ask you, "Come down, my daughter. Come down, my son. Today, I must go into your house." And that house is our heart, the heart that he will dwell, so that at the last day, he will welcome us into his Father's kingdom. If I had not accepted that message, today I would not be here as your deacon, preaching to you, telling you how much God has loved us. When we receive communion today, tell Jesus, "I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed." Amen.
Amen. Thank you.